No. No, this can't be right. All that fanfare for an empty room? There's some secret here. There must be. Do your Pathfinder thing. Oh, you're good.
And I make it look so easy. How far down do you think it goes?
That can't be air pressure. Electrostatic? Ah, gravitation. Oh, you idiot, PB. That wasn't the front door. This is.
I'll let you know.
Hey! Well,
but where is it taking us?
Embrace the unknown, Ryder. Now this is more like it.
Looks like a bunker. Or a vault?
Whatever you call it. The controls for that atmosphere processor might be down here somewhere.
Let's find out.
Anything could be important. Let's be thorough. Too.
Then we have a way out.
You're not leaving already, are you?
Not until we find those processor controls. Well, if the Remnant aren't using it. Not what we're looking for, but worth getting a record.
You go ahead. I've got your back.
Look there, do you see that?
Looks like a broken information display.
Got anything?
There's Element Zero threaded through all this tech. Imagine the engineering that would take.
No signs of any cat. Maybe they can't get into the vault.
But you can. That'll get their attention.
Lucky me. Only minimal power. I don't think it triggered the atmosphere processor, but...
Pathfinder, a conduit beneath the floor just activated. Fluid is running through it. It could be generating emergency power. Your scanner will have more details.
Now that's interesting.
I see the conduit, Sam. Whatever it is, it leads out of the room.
Wow. I really was just scratching the surface.
Phrase recovered. Must read to access. This console links to surface facilities.
Then it must control the atmosphere processor.
No glyphs. It looks dead, or locked down, like most of this place.
The fluid conduit leads to this console and further into the vault.
So if we follow that conduit, it might lead to the system lockdown.
These data pattern things are incredible. If I'm right, each one can hold hundreds of zettabytes. There are whole species who get by with less.
Minor corruption detected. The pattern suggests significant data present, but it cannot be accessed.
Another gravity well, and that's new.
What is it?
A symbol of authority? A key? It's easy to speculate with Remnant, but we need more facts. I'll see what I can find on this beauty. Maybe over this way.
Whatever has this place on lockdown is that way.
I do my best work solo. You fix up the vault, I'll investigate the relic, and together we'll figure this place out.
You don't watch many horror vids, do you? We have no idea what's down here.
And we never will if we miss something because we're huddled in a group. I'll be careful.
Just stay on the radio.
I'm on frequency 145.8. Stay safe.
10 credits say she ends up in a pit of spikes.
This gravity well's sealed off. No way through.
Incidentally, a gravity well is the gravitational effect of a large mass in space. This is more accurately a well with variable gravity.
Keep a note for our sorry friend, and for when we try to explain all this. Well, look at this. No way through, no interface points. Sam, note it down for later.
No interface connectivity detected. The barrier cannot be removed manually.
Too bad.
Comm check. It's... well, you know who.
We read you, PB. Stay in touch. They dug this place through solid rock.
Look up there. Must be how they kept it from collapsing.
That liquid?
Unable to classify.
The only way through is down towards it.
An unknown alloy and other materials. The composition resembles Omnigel.
Maybe that's the fluid in the conduit. Ah, watch yourselves, it burns. So whatever that liquid... Remnant!
Careful, don't fall in that liquid!
Use the pillars for cover! Blast shield. That might be handy.
My God.
All this for an atmosphere processor? What is this place?
Dried up. Unless turning that conduit on started it all flowing again, wouldn't that be something?
Another aqueduct. How many do they need?
If it really is like Omnigel, that fluid could be what's keeping this place going.
Are those roads down there? I can't even see where they end.
Oh,
Eyes up! Don't let them get above us!
Keep up the pressure! We're almost through!
We're good!
The atmosphere processor we found before didn't need all these steps. Dad just interfaced with it directly.
And it didn't work out so great.
Direct intervention was necessary in that case, but clearly unwise.
Be another gravity well? The well's sealed. Damn. Maybe we can use the conduit for emergency power, same as before.
Better safe than sorry. Take them out!
You're sure this well isn't gonna open up under us?
Understood.
This device appears defensive in nature.
No good! Lock down against hostiles!
Wonder if I'd get anything on the scanner. The conduit splits and goes through each of those devices.
Interfacing may complete the circuit and allow the well to open.
If it gets us to the system lockdown, let's try. Device is online and makes a shield. At least it's friendly.
Layers and layers of defenses. If they're defenses.
Gravity well remains in lockdown. Power restored to the gravity well. The conduit leads down. Conduit flow pressure is variable. There could be activity below.
Then let's dig deeper.
Barely any dust. How old is this place?
Unknown. Radiation counts indicate the vault has been offline for several hundred years.
Around the time the Scourge appeared? That can't be a coincidence. Maybe the Scourge is why all this tech was abandoned? A gauntlet. Or maybe a hand tool.
Our scientists will love it either way.
Crap. The conduit's spraying a leak.
Careful! No way you can interface with the console like that.
And no fluid means no power. Damn it. Maybe that's why those devices up above were turned off. We're not turning back now. There has to be some way to fix the leak.
Ryder! Up here! What happened? I can't get indoors to work.
The conduit's breached.
Hey, wait! The observers were using weird laser frequencies to fix a broken wall back there. I can send the frequencies to your Omni-tool. Maybe they can patch up the conduit?
And received. I'll give them a shot. The system's responding to those frequencies. Just a patch job, but it should hold.
Nice work. If it's fixed, that console should work now.
Looks like it worked.
There's even a bridge. You're a pal, Ryder.
Where are you going?
We've got to be close to the system lockdown by now. First one gets the glory.
We'll catch up. Let's see if we powered up a way out of here. Will you look at that?
How do we get across?
I did it.
Watch your step. It's still a long drop. Wait, plants? All the way down here?
You see them too? Thought all the gravity fun had messed up my eyes.
No sunlight, no water. They should all be dead.
The source of the system lockdown may yield more information. We appear to be close. Hydraulics compensating. Ugh.
That bit's slippery.
We've got a path to... Whoa!
Two gravity wells down already, and this place goes even deeper. What's at the bottom?
Let's not find out the hard way.
Jump jets. Platform's resonating with something. We must be close. No question. This is the heart of the vault.
I've never seen anything like it.
All conduits converge here, Pathfinder.
That must be the lockdown console.
Thoughts, Sam?
Unknown, though it appears related to the lockdown. An in-depth study may reveal its purpose. The system lockdown is disabled. The vault and the atmosphere processor should return to full operation.
Ryder, you fixed the lockdown, didn't you?
The whole place is lighting up. Power readings are off the chart.
Really, really off the chart.
But if it's back online, we should be... good. Two.
Should we... go! Phoebe, get back to the entrance now!
I saw it! What is that thing?
Don't risk it, just go! Watch out! Vents!
I looked back, why did I look back?
Too far to jump! Got another bridge?
Wise to escape, Ryder.
I know, Sam!
Taking it! It's still coming! It's sweeping the whole vault! Kill anything in its
Like us! The barrier's gone!
Get that thing if you want, but it's going to be close.
That's the door to the entrance. Almost there!
Hassan is attempting surface reconnection.
Come on!
Board restart is now complete.
That was... talk about a rush!
What was that... field?
Might have been sweeping the vault, or chasing us.
An immune response? Maybe one last scrub before startup? This place is full of surprises.
Nothing like outrunning death.
Or reactivating a huge mysterious vault. Nice going.
Atmosphere processor is online. Recovering last console activity.
Is that the Helios cluster?
Yeah. There we are. That's Eos.
Whoa. Did restarting the system do that?
If that light is us, then all these points could be vaults in other worlds. Dormant like this one.
Maybe. But why is there a whole network of them? What's all this for?
This tech can create observers from nowhere, or ravage a whole planet. And that's just what we've seen. The bots, those plants back there, the atmosphere processors.
Back home, some corporation hit a desert world with an ice comet. They changed the atmosphere to bring rain.
To help with support life.
That first processor we saw was making things worse, but maybe it malfunctioned.
Is that what these builders were trying to do? Make worlds habitable? Even terraform a whole cluster?
Hey, look there. That's different. Maybe it's active? We've got to go see.
Sam?
Extrapolating. These coordinates lie beyond the space we have currently surveyed, Pathfinder.
Mark it on our charts. We need more to go on. Let's head up to the surface. I could use some fresh air. Look at that sky.
How? No atmosphere processor works that fast.
If this effect is representative, Pathfinder, air and moisture patterns will show noticeable improvement. Eos could support an outpost.
A foothold. That's all we need. Just enough to begin. This remnant technology could be the key to our survival, if we can control it.
You can. Kind of. Still, wouldn't hurt to find a manual.
We've got a lead. Sam marked it on the charts down there. That site is active, whatever it is. Who knows what we'll find there.
We? You want to come along?
I want to know what makes the Remnant tick. You've got a key to their technology. Or a crowbar, at least.
Welcome aboard. We'll get you a fancy job title to go over your bunk.
I only need a footlocker. Data pad, toothbrush, clean underwear, that'll do. I'll catch up with you.
Well, this will be interesting.
Now for our new outpost.
You have already logged an idle site. Nav point noted. Updating Tempest.
The Nexus is on pins and needles, Ryder. Pods are inbound and ready.
Let's go make it happen.
So, Kura. Asari Commandos. I hear a lot of things.
You hear, or you watch low-budget action vids?
Either way, Huntresses hunt. They sabotage. They do assassinations.
All officially sanctioned.
And that was all fine with you?
Yeah. Hunt down anti-Citadel fanatics, or let Crisis Response mop up the blood later. That's not a choice.
This is resonating now. Probably with the vault.
I've picked up readings of Nexus-issued equipment nearby.
The person who left this behind, she was part of the first wave of colonists, wasn't she?
The probability is high. This researcher may have left data pads at other remnant sites as well. Ahead. They appear to be fighting a Krogan.
Is that Drac? Here they come!
About time you joined the party.
Reloading!
Think I made them angry? Good.
Save some for me, old man!
That's it, kid. Keep it up. Good one.
Got them all.
That fight was fun.
You're telling me?
You could really handle yourself, kid. And I hear you're the one to thank for clearing up the sky. Had your number all wrong.
So the clouds parted, and these Ket look pretty keeled over. Maybe us humans can pull our weight after all.
Well, you can, clearly. But there's a lot to do before I'd be that smug about it. You know what? I'm gonna ignore my gut and join up. This fight was good, and we can do it again. And before you go saying you don't need a Krogan, believe me, you do.
That's what I said.
The first colonists sent audio logs about these regions back to the Nexus.
And?
Fairwinds Basin. Lowest radiation count in the area. Little bit of hope.
Maybe more than a little.
Radiation levels normal.
This is where we'll build our new outpost.
A real beginning.
Prepping deployment order. You must choose what purpose this new outpost will serve.
The Nexus doesn't get a say?
Resources are at a crisis point. Protocol states this judgment call falls to the Pathfinder. With current supplies, you could build a military outpost, focusing on defense and militia training. Alternatively, a scientific outpost could advance the initiative's research and discoveries.
What do you think? Military outpost or scientific?
Pathfinder's call, but research is no good if we're dead. Military.
It's got to be science. Our colonists need to understand their home.
Be advised that the first outpost placed by a Pathfinder will be a statement in itself. Fair or not, your choice will represent the initiative and its intentions in Andromeda. Consider carefully.
Prioritize research and discovery. That's our foundation. And our future.
Orders prepped. Ready on your signal.
Andromeda Initiative, this is Ryder. Pathfinder.
EOS is ready for deployment.
Copy that. Outpost block inbound. And ready as hell. August Bradley, operational head for this block. Mayor now, I suppose. We're ready to make the most of what you delivered.
I feel like I should toss you the keys. Be nice. It's been through a lot.
Understood. Prodromos. That's what we're calling her.
They're eager. I haven't seen Eager for months. Eos is far from golden. But now it's a producer. A real and reasonable first step. They think you did the impossible. The Nexus. I warned them, hoping was irresponsible. You proved me wrong, Pathfinder.
What are you playing at? Seems like being my friend is suddenly valuable.
Fair assumption. The reality, Ryder? You brought us time. But one outpost on a long-shot planet won't stop us from starving. You already have a lead on something else?
The nav point from the vault.
Now it gets complicated. The others are ready to officially sanction your efforts, to be a part of your success. We all want the initiative to succeed. But after failing for so long, no one agrees on how to do it. Be aware. That's all.
We didn't come to a new galaxy to argue about who's right.
It got us this far. Talk to Bradley. Later, we'll go over the extended job of Pathfinder. Until then. Tan's waiting on the Nexus.
Detecting above normal.
Sorry it came to this, Pathfinder.
Sam, another memory trigger?
Yes, though my memory array remains locked. Additional triggers are required.
Pathfinder, Major Domo Evan Bell Scott. I have headaches, so you don't have to. Rather, so Bradley doesn't have to. I've also coordinated with your Ket expert. He wanted me to remind you to find him.
I didn't assign a Ket expert to Prodromos.
Then he's a hell of a self-motivator. Here's the nav, anyway. Precision is important.
How did you come to the Initiative?
Like many, I was lost and looking for a purpose. That sounds loftier than it felt at the time. I was an insufferable ass. The training for the trip was probably enough to cure me of it. But I always took things too far. Didn't know how to stop alienating people until I was the alien. See? Still insufferable.
Sounds like you left some interesting circumstances.
I miss the family, and maybe they miss me. But that doesn't mean I'd go back. I mean, we can't, but still. I like where I came from. It's a great place to be from. You know what I mean?
I know exactly how you feel. Couldn't wait to be from somewhere.
Like a bullet leaves a gun. Sometimes you just gotta go.
Where'd you launch out of?
The pale blue dot, Terra Prime. Big old boring Earth. I miss that wet dog smell after the first snow melts. I don't know why. What about you? Miss anything?
I miss the time on the couch before media loads. Make your choice, and as a B-minus rom-com bounces between satellites, the size of the planet decides how long you wait in the dark.
Your popcorn sounds nice, Pathfinder.
Another time.
Of course. What do you need, Pathfinder?
Thoughts on how the outpost is doing? The planet?
Stellar. We keep it up. We'll make this world look like the brochures.
Thoughts on your boss?
The old man. He's pretty tied into what happens here. I just pick up the day-to-day scraps. Good at cracking the whip for these science types. Doesn't fall for the details. I hope he's proud. Feels like he's proud.
Any trouble with the Ket?
Clearing the sky cleared it for the bad guys as well as us. So some uptick in hostility was to be expected. We've some tricks up our sleeves, thanks to the research teams. That only goes so far. Your expert is still out there. He'd have more current information than I.
Another time.
Of course.
Mayor Bradley.
Pathfinder, good to see you. We're busy as anything, thanks to you. Bit dusty, but we can adapt. It's worth it when it's your own.
Let's not drive people too hard. Rough enough getting this far.
Nothing you see here came from cracking a whip. Everyone is just ready. You go do what you need to on the Nexus. Follow that dot. There will be more to do on Eos later. Some key positions: Connor Supply, Ramirez Medical, Abrams Science, Falks Engineering. With them and my Major Domo, we won't end up like Site 1 and 2.
The first two outposts didn't have a chance. It was clear to everyone on the ground.
I saw the brief. I'm making sure every one of our people is eyes wide. You changed this planet, but that doesn't make it easy. We'll use the efforts of those who went before. Good people, every last one. I'd have been honored to fail with any of them.
I haven't reached the end of that trail, but not everyone died outright.
Right. They tell me there were staggered evacs. If any want to try again, they're welcome. Oh, and Pathfinder, this is for you. It's our flag. Hang it where the Nexus can see. It's touched the soil of our first outpost in Andromeda. Make it real. Head for the Nexus. Must be waiting, Pathfinder. Relax. There will be more for you on Eos after you get back.
What's behind naming the outpost Prodromos?
It means Forerunner. Languages bore the shit out of me, but we voted fair. That ownership is key to the Initiative. That's how you convince a bunch of civilians to jump galaxies. As long as we meet our obligations to the Nexus, what we build and how we organize, we get to figure it out.
Tell me about yourself.
August Bradley, retired from the Alliance. I keep the discipline, but not so much the doctrine. I joined the Initiative because it's a frontier. Not a lot of those left. Not that you can reach on my pension anyway.
Any family?
A niece on Earth. We didn't talk after my sister passed.
I've had similar happen to my family.
Yes, well, we stay out of people's grief.
My father, your sister. Sounds like we've both lost a lot.
We stay out of people's grief, Pathfinder.
What is that? Stay out of people's grief. You've said it before.
Shit, that's right. You didn't have the block leader death talk. The thing is, you and your father, not unique, just recent. Every initiative species, except maybe Asari and Krogan, went into cryo with friends and family and woke up knowing they were all dead. Everything we build begins with that. The unsaid start to the initiative. So yeah, we stay out of people's grief.
How do you keep it from just spilling out?
I let it. And my people stay out of it when I do. And I stay out of theirs. What's that old saying? Children with dead parents think everything is possible and nothing is safe? That seems like it fits anyone in the initiative. Or maybe everyone.
Any insights about the people running the show from the Nexus?
I only work with Addison. She's by the book. And with all the shit that happened, that's to her credit.
And the others?
I only work with Addison.
Anything you'd say if you weren't in their direct employ?
If I wasn't in their direct employ, I'd give that rat's nest a wide berth. Outposts deal with Addison. She deals with the others. And I don't envy her.
What can you say about the Prodromos block?
Exacting bunch. As the science types always are. We'll eventually allow the staking of claims for groups with enough startup resources. Not quite Gold Rush, not quite Landmines. Honored to lead them for as long as they need me.
Just looking for a status report. Informal, of course.
Not much to report. We're making life up as we go.
We'll talk another time.
Oh, and Pathfinder. What I said about grief? Every pirate we brought to this cluster woke up with the same reality you did. Maybe think about that when shooting doesn't have to start.
Hello there.
Pathfinder? Mind giving me your opinion on this? I'm planning classes for our first school, when we have one. Some say we shouldn't teach Milky Way history. All irrelevant now, apparently.
We were all shaped by that history. Our children deserve to know how and why.
Agreed. Maybe you'll change a few minds. Thanks for stopping.
Ah, Pathfinder. I hear you're to thank for a physics-defying atmosphere processor.
That's me. I'm Ryder.
Hanley Abrams, Director of Scientific Research on EOS, and writer of papers that start What the Hell Weather. But, new galaxy, new world, and a really new start. Gotta keep up. How can I help you?
Activating that vault changed the planet. Anything to worry about?
Considering its world-altering technology we've never encountered before, I hope not. But the storms show no signs of returning, and I know who to contact for remnant tech support. I'll take it.
What do you make of Lieutenant Bradley?
Determined as hell. And he has incredible faith in us to get this done. Bradley would carry this outpost on his back if he had to, and we'll make sure he never has to.
What kind of research are you working on?
Your basic first in scientific work, soil, water, atmospherics, plus studying remnant tech, because now I need to understand that to survive here.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
Back home, I was filling test tubes in some dead-end lab. People knew me as Stefan, but that was never who I was. I knew what I could do, and I knew who I wanted to do it as. Hanley Abrams, Andromeda Explorer. That's me. Feels good. Feels right.
What made you choose the name Hanley?
It's the initials of all my favorite places back home. My fiancé helped me pick it before we left. When it's time, I'm hoping Bradley will perform our wedding ceremony.
I've gotta go.
Keep up the good work.
Hello, Kim Connor. Supplies, trade, procurement. Anything you need, I can provide. Though I hear you've got Vetra Nix keeping you well stocked.
You know Vetra?
I worked with her on the Nexus in those days of chaos. But I need ground under my feet, and soon hopefully trade will flourish on Eos.
So how did you end up here, Connor?
Me? You're the Grand Explorer. I fill out requisition forms.
Really? Everyone here has some kind of story.
I left mine back home. Or... the... still... ask me another time.
Does the outpost have everything it needs?
The Nexus furnished us with the basics, but that isn't enough for a home. Providing the rest is my responsibility. The labs can't work without good logistics. They'll have it.
Is Eos trading with any new partners?
Right now, just the Nexus. But I have contracts with Wildcat Salvages and independent miners. There will be more.
You said you know Vetra. What's she really like?
Ah, Vetra. You're lucky to have her. Few weathered the mutiny on the Nexus as gracefully. The mutineers tried to convince her to join them. She refused, yet many of them are still her contacts and allies. If Vetra Nix has advice for you, I'd listen.
See you later.
Be well. Come back again.
Pathfinder. Jacob Mitney, Research and Development. My team's just getting set up here, but we've made a discovery you might want to check out.
All ears.
We've put together a blueprint for augmenting your armor plating. Uploading it now. If you can collect the necessary resources from around Eos, it should work.
Is this a sure thing, Mitney, or just pie in the sky?
I have no interest in wasting your time. This could form the basis for armor production across the Initiative. Scrounge safely, Pathfinder.
Pathfinder, this is the spot where Nigel McCoy wanted you to leave his pendant.
In honor of his brother, Dash McCoy.